Police in our state are preparing for an increase in DWIs related to marijuana.
Come next week, marijuana will be legal, and with growing questions about driving while high, law enforcement officials drew several parallels to driving while drunk.
If troopers encounter a vehicle and it smells like the occupants have been smoking marijuana, you can bet that that trooper is going to be looking further into that situation to see if there's a violation either of the open container law, which includes the prohibition against using any marijuana or cannabis product while in a vehicle.
Colonel Matt Langer, chief of the Minnesota State Police, says drug-impaired driving has already been on the rise.
Drug driving accounts for just under 7,000 DWI incidents from a period of time between 2012 and 2016, compared with just under 16,000 incidents from 2017 to 2021.
That's a 127% increase in drug driving. Fatal crash numbers also tell a story.
So far, as of today, at least 197 Minnesotans have lost their lives in crashes on Minnesota roads. Of that 197, 29 of those fatalities are directly attributed to an alcohol-impaired driver. 21 of those fatalities are directly attributed to a drug-impaired driver. And 13 of those fatalities are attributed to a combination of drugs and alcohol impairing a driver.
As a part of getting tougher on drugs, if officers suspect a driver is impaired by something other than alcohol, they can request a drug recognition evaluator or a DRE to come assist with further investigation.
It's looking at body temperature, it's looking at blood pressure, it's looking at pupil size, all kinds of things like that. So it's a scientifically validated and internationally accepted protocol that is used by a highly trained law enforcement officer.
Plus, the state is also working on a pilot program for 1 year on oral fluid testing.
The oral fluid project is a device that officers may use at roadside to evaluate a driver and confirm that their observations of impairment are the direct result of an impairing substance other than alcohol.
So far, participation in this project is voluntary, and results from it cannot be used against the driver.
It is not admissible in any court action. It is not admissible for any driver's license sanctions. This is simply a data collection exercise, as well as an exercise that will help us to evaluate and certify the oral fluid technology that is currently available out there.